This story consists of my recollections of a very unusual young man with whom I was thrown into contact at long intervals. In the summer of 1919, while passing through Chicago on my way to the Far East, a friend of mine, Elliot Templeton, whom I had known in London and Paris, invited me to dine with him and his sister, Mrs. Bradley. They were giving a dinner party at one of those sprawling country clubs which was so much a part of the American scene in the early days of the post-war boom. Mr. Templeton's table?
Yes, sir.
Are they here?
They're having refreshments, sir.
Here you are.
With a dry martini, sir.
Prohibition of all the bloody nonsense.
Elliot.
Yes, dear.
Who is this man that you asked to dinner tonight? I had to get Sophie at the last minute or we would have been 13.
He's an English author. He's quite all right. In fact, he's really quite famous. So pretend that you've heard of him, even if you haven't.
That's too much. Get the other glasses. Elliot, you must be slipping if you frequent authors.
Not at all, my dear. Authors go everywhere nowadays. Why, in London, I even met actors and actresses in society. Ah, here he is now. My dear fella, how very nice to see you.
Hello, Elliot.
Let me present you to my sister, Mrs. Bradley. Louisa. Louisa, dear, this is Mr. Somerset Maugham.
How do you do, Mr. Maugham? It's an honor to have you with us.
Thank you. It's very nice to be here.
What on earth are you doing in this benighted city?
I'm just passing through. But you, Elliot, I thought you never left Paris.
Why should I? In point of fact, I came to see my sister, my niece, Isabel. I haven't been back since before the war. I hope you don't mind. A few young things are joining us for dinner, but we can leave early.
Why should I mind? I like young things if they're good to look at.
Who is this man that you asked for dinner tonight? I had to get Sophie at the last minute or we would have been 13.
He's an English author. He's quite all right. In fact, he's really quite famous. So pretend that you've heard of him, even if you haven't.